Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, please subscribe, hit that notification bell so you know each time I upload a new video. Today's video is about my Soho Disco bag in all leather, and I have the red version. This bag comes in different colors. There's a nude color, there's a black color, but it took me so long to decide what color to get. Black would go with everything. Red does go with everything, but did I want something that stands out so much? It turns out that I did. And I just thought the nude one was just too simple. You know what I mean? I needed something with a pop of color for the spring and summer, even winter. Sometimes, you know, everybody's wearing like dark colors. You just want something that stands out and pops and brings a bit of brightness, you know, to your outfit. And this was perfect. And I love this style. Let's just say that right now, because one, it is a crossbody. It is hands-free, so it means I can run around and do as many things as I want without having one hand holding a bag the whole time or getting my hands tired or whatever. And it is such a good size to fit whatever you want to throw in there. We'll put some things in here so I can show you what I fit in here and how I organize this bag or what I use it for. So anyway, let's just talk about the measurements. The length is 21 centimeters, the height is 17 centimeters, and the width is 7 centimeters. The strap is adjustable. At its longest length, it is 55 centimeters, and it is a fantastic crossbody on my height. My height is 1.64 meters, which is 164 centimeters. I hope that helps you out. And yes, so it has this embossed interlock GG, as you can see there. Gold tone hardware all around. It has this leather tassel. Just adds a bit of character to the bag. And yes, it's a very simple design, camera style bag, with that top zip, and you know, nothing too complicated going on here. No other pockets on the outside. The inside is very plain and dirty. Okay, it's very dirty in there. I have had this bag way before I started using SLGs in my bags to protect the inside. You know, lipstick stains, food stains, I don't know. Who knows what stains they are at this point. I obviously need to clean it out a little bit. And this side pocket one and another one on this side as well. And that's it. And then one large compartment in the middle. Now, when I use this bag, as you can see, I don't have an organizer in there. I literally throw things in here. As you can see, I do not have a bag organizer or anything of that sort. And as I mentioned, this was before I had all those mini pochettes, those, you know, Chanel mini pouch to keep my bag organized. So in this video, I will just basically throw things in here. Let's do that real quick and then we can talk more about the bag, pros and cons, and whether it suits different types of lifestyles. So let's see what we can put in here. I would put my phone, of course, and a hand cream, of course, a perfume. Now, I had a perfume, what was it? YSL Manifesto, And if you have not seen my review of that perfume, go ahead and watch the perfume review. I will link the video in the description box. I did mention that, you know, my bottle was broken because I had put my perfume bottle in this bag. And you know what happened? The bag flipped, the strap flipped, and everything, all the contents in my bag spilled in the driveway. Of course, I had not zipped the top zip. The bag was open, silly me, and it flipped. Things fell out. My perfume bottle broke. Luckily, no perfume spilled. I will show you how that happens with this bag. Anyway, let's continue putting things inside. I have hand sanitizer, lipsticks, Lime Crime, Pretty Zombie, Dior, this is a mascara, YSL Volupte Tinting Balm. I think this one's actually almost finished because I love this stuff, you know. Anyways, AirPods. This is how it's looking. Chanel lipstick. Love this. Gum. Okay. Sunglasses. So this is everything in here. That's the bag closed. See how much stuff fits in here? A lot, okay? And there is still room in there. Like, a lot fits in here. And it's leather, so it can stretch. It's not a structured bag. Over time, the shape will kind of change. You know, it'll become a little bit floppy. But at the moment, mine is looking good. I would keep it stuffed with like air paper or whatever you want to put in here, just so you can keep the structure and keep your bags in a dust bag, please. Okay. All that moist or whatever, you know, it's just better for the bag. That's my thought on it. And the inside is really dirty. I have no clue how I'm going to clean this. I will have to figure out and look on the website and see how they advise I clean this bag. This bag is actually one of the most affordable of luxury bags. If you are starting out in your luxury collection or you into designer bags and you kind of don't, you're not ready to pay those, you know, $2,000, $3,000, you know, it's a lot of money. I remember when I first started buying bags, okay? Luxury bags to be specific. There was a time when I was very, very, very young and I always thought that I wasn't really a bag person. But when you really looked at it, I had a lot of bags, okay? I used to buy Coach bags. I think I've only owned two Coach bags in my whole life. I have owned a Teddy Blake bag, one, and I had like 10 Colette bags. My mom would see all these bags set up, 10, 15, actually more. And she'd say, oh, you really love bags. Like, you need to slow down though. And I would just be like, no, I don't love bags. But I needed a different bag for each outfit. So the thing with these Colette bags and these, they're like fast fashion bags. Very trendy, and when you look at it, I used to be scared of that whole $1,000 something for one bag, but honestly, where are those bags now? I have no clue, okay? Some have been broken, dirty, and I could not keep them, so I had to get rid of them, and for that many bags, I could have bought one really good bag that would have lasted me all this time. And I know some people like to change styles a lot, which is fair enough, and you want to try different bags with different outfits and you just don't want to spend that much money. But for me, for my life and where I want to head or what kind of life I'm trying to set up for myself, I think buying classic designer bags, quality bags, they don't have to be Gucci or anything. Coach is really good. Teddy Blake have all leather bags, good quality. Just don't buy trendy. I'm not a trendy person because it's going to be out of style within 2 years. And then what are you going to do with that bag? You could be thinking she is crazy spending all this money on bags, but I'm going to have my bag for longer because especially this shape, in 10, 15 years, they're gonna be making different types of bags, but similar styles. Do you know what I mean? It's timeless. So if you're getting started, this is a good bag to have. This will take you through different occasions, and the price is much better than other bags. It's about $1,600 and something dollars at the moment on the Gucci website. That's in Australian dollars. But you can buy it pre-loved and save a couple hundred dollars. But if you're starting in designer stuff, this is actually a pretty good price. This is my errands bag, chilled out, lunch, brunch kind of vibe. On the website it says night out. I guess other people would use it as a night out or clubbing, but I wouldn't. This is not a clubbing style for me. Pros and cons. Ooh, let's start with pros. I think I've already listed some. The style is perfect for everyday use. The size is great to put essentials when you're going out. And the strap makes it convenient because it's hands-free. The leather is good because it gives you way to kind of stuff things in there, as many things as you want. And it's the casual look because of the leather. Gold tone hardware, love gold tone. It's my thing, it's my jam, okay. The tassel is nice, adds character. Okay, cons. I didn't want to have to say it, but as I mentioned, the little story with my perfume. So I have the zip open like this, and I was putting on the bag, you know, over my shoulder, you know how it goes, and the strap wasn't sitting right. It twisted and the contents fell. Now, you don't want to be out somewhere, you forget to close the zip, because sometimes you just want the convenience of having a zip open, put your hand in and out. But you should not do that with this bag. Always have it closed, because if the strap twists for any reason, and it does, your contents will fall out. The price, is the bag worth it? Yes, it is worth it. Although I have to say, there are other more affordable brands, Coach, Teddy Blake, to name a few. There are many others, and that make the similar style, you know, this is like the camera bag style. If you do not have $1,600, go ahead and look at alternative brands. You do not have to have a bag that says Gucci, has the Gucci logo on it. You can get other bags that are a lot more affordable, but similar style. And I would just say, get something that is durable, that is a good leather, just so you can be able to use the bag for many years to come. You don't want a bag that you spend how much ever money you want to spend and then have to throw it out because it won't last as long. The quality is not as good. But yes, the other thing I like about designer or luxury brands, sometimes they allow you to bring in the bag and they can fix certain things about the bag if you are not happy or if it malfunctions. Anything of that sort. That does it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and leave me a comment below. Let me know what are your thoughts on this bag and anything that I said in this video. I hope you subscribed, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.